Agree.
Hi, Lori.
How are you?
I'm doing well, waiting for the snow.
My goodness.
This is crazy.
I know.
Hey, Brian.
How are you?
How's it going?
Hey. How are you?
Sorry, just us today.
Yeah. Apparently.
So far.
The door is open.
I know.
Yeah.
Who got the room?
Yesterday, Monday, I left the door closed somehow. So I had like students knocking on the window. Freaked me out.
So they're gonna be doing a presentation. When is that?
Oh my god, yeah, this is the topic. Their topics are arranged on a tradition that each of them follows.
Right.
So some of them are like town square lighting, like board game night for like they do every night as a family. There was Thanksgiving, Dia de Muertos. I have them on here. And they're just like incredible. Three kings, Day of Father's Day, Mother's Day, Day of the Children, family reunion, birthdays. So then they get to present that on the 13th of the 16th.
Okay.
Which is not next week, the next.
Yes.
In English. So then on Monday, we move into an editing workshop where the volunteers go help me go one by one to correct the essays and make sure that they're approved and ready to go. And then Wednesday with you, they're going to pronunciation workshop.
Okay. Oh,
so all of you will be working one-on-one with a student, and then you read the essay as many times as they need.
Yeah.
And
they can record it.
And we can record it. They bring your phone. Oh, my God. So that's Wednesday. And then the last week will be presentation for the majority of the class. And then at the end, we do games, like holiday games. Nothing around, obviously, what we're talking about.
Yeah.
But nothing serious nor teaching anything. So it's things.
And which week is it?
The 13th and the 16th.
13 and 16.
So not next, the following.
For sure.
Yes, I'm so excited.
And then the week of Christmas, do we have that week? Do we have a class?
We're off until the January 4th.
Oh,
yes. Hola, Vero. Hi, girl. Hi, everyone. Welcome.
It's my sister.
Oh, I got a lack of snow. It's not.
I think it's
not, he's not ready yet.
And those guys won't leave her until next spring.
Hola, buenas tardes.
Hola, Maribel. ¿Me escuchas?
Sí, escucho bien, gracias.
Super. ¿Te llegó el correo con el enlace?
Ayer lo hice. El de ayer, ¿no? El que me mandaste, sí, gracias.
Yo se lo dejo saber entonces.
Gracias.
Possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. So the big difference between these two plans, okay, they both talk about possession, possessive. Algo de pertenencia, okay? It's to describe ownership. Para describir a quién le pertenecen las cosas, usando pronombres y evitando repetir nombres, okay? Porque sabes de qué estás hablando. En vez de estar diciendo Lena's jacket is my favorite because I love Lena's jacket. You're saying it twice, right? So it's not really necessary. No es necesario repetir tanto el sustantivo de una persona, ¿verdad? Ay, Mati, el sustantivo con el diciendo a quién le pertenece. Podemos usar el pronombre, el adjetivo, okay? Now this is the trick. Este es el truco. Possessive adjectives are the easy ones. Okay, possessive adjetivos son los fáciles. Son los que decimos my jacket or her jacket or his jacket. ¿Verdad? Sigamos todo esto. My, our, his, her, our classroom. Yeah. Or their paper. Okay, estamos hablando de Eric, Judy, and Emilia. Okay, this is plural, right? Plural. Their paper. En vez de decir Erika, Judy's, and Miriam's paper, we're just going to say their paper, ¿verdad? Para enseñar de qué le pertenece. Lo más importante. The most important thing, the way you know a sentence is telling you something belongs to someone. La manera que tú sabes que una oración describe que algo le pertenece a alguien is you have to read the sentence. Tienen que leer la oración. On Monday, a few volunteers mentioned that a lot of you are not reading the sentence. Okay, and that's how it's hard. For you identify the pronoun. Uno de los comentarios del lunes me comentó que muchos de ustedes no están leyendo la oración para poder entonces identificar el pronombre correctamente. Tienen que siempre, de hoy a mayo, siempre leer su oración. Su oración le da muchísima información. That your sentence is always going to give you a lot of information and is always going to tell you if it is talking about something that belongs to someone. Y te va a decir si la persona está hablando de algo que le pertenece a alguien. Okay? The possessive, this is this one. Okay? Possessive adjective is this one. The possessive pronoun that we've been talking about. Is the one that replaces the noun. I'm going to give you a Spanish example. Y le voy a dar el ejemplo en español. Está bien fácil. En español, nosotros decimos mi jacket y decimos esto es mío. Nosotros no usamos jacket cuando estamos diciendo esto es mío. Porque no vas a decir este es mío jacket. O este es mío caso. ¿Verdad que no? Mío es lo mismo que mine. Mine y mío es lo mismo. It's the same thing in Spanish. So you're going to use, instead of Lena's jacket, I'm just going to say, it's mine, or it is mine. ¿Verdad? Porque ya estamos sabemos que estamos hablando del jacket. I'm going to use, for example, it's mine, and all it's, or get to something about both of mine. It is. Exacto. It is mine. Esto no es otro pronombre. Vamos a usar dos pronombres en la misma oración. We're not going to use two pronouns in the same sentence, right? So I'm saying, it's mine. I can say, it's yours. ¿Verdad? Es tuyo. En lo cual que esto es tu jacket, esto es tuyo. Es lo mismo. O sea, que en español sería tuyo, mío, no. Mío. Entonces, we have his, It's his, the él, it's hers, hers, con la S al final, de ella. We can say, it's ours, de nosotros. Okay, does that help a little? Eso ayuda un poquito a entender la diferencia. Es lo mismo que en español. En español no vamos a usar el posesivo pronombre y no sustantivo, sino usamos esto es mío, esto es tuyo, esto es de ella, esto es de él. Es lo mismo. La diferencia, when, how we know which one, cómo sabemos cuál usar, is because the sentence is telling you, for example, so if I have a sentence that says that we're using possessive pronouns, or my left side, this is possessive pronouns, these are possessive adjectives. So if we have, if we have, for example, my jacket is red. We said earlier, you can say Lina's jacket. So we know that if there's a noun and there's, there's a noun and a possession. Si sabes que tienes la persona con el artículo que está describiendo de quién es, you can always use a possessive adjective. You don't have to choose between one or the other, okay? It depends on what you're trying to say. Dependiendo de lo que tú estás tratando de decir. You can always say, my jacket is broken, or the car, his car is red, or broken, if you want to choose similar words. We eat our cake on Fridays. ¿De quién le pertenece el bizcocho? Our, right? So it's telling you you're using the pronoun and you have your noun. Okay, siempre. Here we can say we eat ours. Can I say that or no? No, right? If I'm trying to change this into a possessive.
We need ours.
We need ours.
Yep. We need cake.
Yes, me and cake. Okay, así que aquí, en vez de decir, we eat our cake on Fridays, we eat ours. Sabemos que estamos hablando del bizcocho, no tenemos que decirlo nada más. Okay, es una manera que podemos cortar las oraciones, que podemos, si estamos en una conversación con alguien, que podemos sencillamente usar este pronombre para reemplazar el sustantivo de la misma manera que lo haríamos en español. Que decíamos, esto es nuestro. Ya sabemos que estamos hablando del bizcocho. No tenemos que decir, esto es nuestro bizcocho. No tenemos que repetirlo. Okay? So, possessive pronouns are harder in the sense that you have to figure out, can you use the pronoun to replace the noun? Podemos usar el pronombre para reemplazar el sustantivo. Y una de las maneras más fáciles de hacer eso es siempre acabar la oración con el pronombre. It is hers. It is ours. The jacket is hers. Pero siempre está el final de oración. Especialmente cuando estamos usando los que acaban con S. ¿Ok? Siempre suenan mejor al final de oración o después del verbo. ¿Ok? Entonces, si abrimos nuestro panfletito, if we open our pamphlet, we can see here the first page. Vamos a la primera página donde dice, whose book today. Yeah, we got it, Robin. So we know it is Robin's book. Es el libro de Robin. Si queremos usar posesivo adjetivo, sería it is her book. De la manera que decimos en tu ejemplo. Y si queremos usar possessive pronouns, if you want to use possessive pronoun, the book is hers. You're still using book in the sentence, but you're not saying her book. You're just saying this is hers. Or this book is hers. Cualquiera de los dos funciona. Okay, puede quitar book completamente o puede dejar book y dejar her, poner hers al final. Después del verbo, after the verb. Yeah. Where is your verb?
Dime. Y entonces en possessive, her siempre se usa con la S, no se usa con solo her.
Correcto. Okay. Porque si tienes, if you're going to use it without an S, then it's a possessive adjective.
Okay.
If you're using it with an S, it's possessive pronoun.
Okay.
Good question. Okay, so for example, here, the book is hers, mm-hmm. it's at the end, and it's after the verb. Where is your verb in this sentence? Is, right? So hers is after the verb. Esto es bien importante. Always after the verb. That's why it's usually at the end or almost at the end of the sentence. So if we move to page two, these are the same thing as this. Es lo mismo. Okay, it's just written different. Exactamente lo mismo, pero tablita diferente. Okay. One suggestion that I have, una sugerencia que tengo para ustedes, is if you want, you can cut these, you can make flashcards, and you can quiz yourself. Okay, pueden cortar esto, usarlo como flashcards, como tarjetitas, y se pueden hacer un examen ustedes mismos. Me dicen, you, me, there. Ahí está. O pueden hacer oraciones con ellas también. That's a good thing that you can do with those cheat sheets or the flashcards that you can use at home. And then this is the same thing that we just talked about. There's possessive adjectives. We have mine, your, his, her, its, our, your, and their. Okay? Right here. Los primeros son subject pronouns, the ones that we know a lot about, right? Everyone's an expert on them. So we have possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns right here. So we have mine, que es mío, yours, tuyo, his, de él, hers, de ella, ours, nuestro, yours, plural. Again, remember that we talked about this in singular and subject and object. And theirs. Ojo, tienen ese. Muchos tienen ese en el posesivo pronombre. Mm-hmm. Okay. So make sure. And then if you read on the bottom, we have possessive pronouns never go before a noun. Nunca van antes del sustantivo, ¿verdad? Porque reemplazan el sustantivo. They take the place of a noun. Reemplazan. So they are the subject or object in a sentence. Solamente son el sujeto o el objeto. ¿Qué es el objeto de una oración? Igual que el objeto pronombre. Y quien recibe, ¿verdad? Recibe. Acuérdense, objeto, el objeto es recibido. Sujeto es quien hace la oración, ¿verdad? And so they go before or, after. After the verb. So, for example, that book is mine. No tiene my book. The book is mine. Mine y book están separados. ¿Ven que no están juntos? That house is ours. House y ours no están juntos. Y ours está después del verbo. Ours is after the verb. Yours is the chair on the left. You could have it before. Yours is the chair on the left. Fíjense que yours y chair no están igual. It's not saying your chair. It's saying yours is the chair on the left. Tu silla, la tuya, es la silla que está a la derecha. Okay. Her lunch isn't very good, but his is. Su almuerzo no está muy bueno, pero el de él sí. ¿Okay? Obviamente no tenemos que decir, pero el almuerzo de él sí. Si no decimos, pero el de él sí. No tenemos que repetir almuerzo nuevamente. That's the whole point of a possessive pronoun. Ese es todo el punto del posesivo pronombre. No repetir el sustantivo porque ya sabemos de qué estamos hablando. Okay. And then we move into the last page, which is just puts the two together. Los pone los dos uno al otro y te los compara. Okay. So it tells you possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. Again, it's the same thing as this. Es lo mismo que lo que está aquí. And then very quickly, I'm going to talk about four commonly done mistakes. Voy a hablar de cuatro errores que son muy comunes. Aquí hay tres, pero voy a añadir uno más de acuerdo al examen de ustedes. And so we have your and your. Who knows what this means? You are. Yes, very good, Yadira. You are. This does not mean, this is not a pronoun. No es un pronombre. Muy similar a nuestro pronombre, pero no es un pronombre. Cuando significa you con esa apóstrofe, significa you are. You're in my English class. You are in my English class. It's the same thing. Okay? The other, and here you have the sentences. Is that your dog? Possessive adjective, right? Está diciendo tu perro. And you're not listening to me. You are not listening to me. It's the same thing as this. Es lo mismo. This is, it is. This is is. This is a pronoun. This is not a pronoun. Okay, esto es un pronombre, esto no es un pronombre. Okay? Esto significa it is. Okay? Apóstrofe, vamos a dar una clase entera de apóstrofe. For example, it's a nice day. It is a nice day. Or, what's wrong with its paw? What does paw mean? Mira esa palabra. Patita un perro. ¿Verdad? Mira esa palabra nueva, look at that new vocabulary. Paw, la pata de un perro. You want to say that word with me? Paw. Paw. My master, I can never say, I can never enunciate, sorry. And then the last one is,
no, two more.
There, and there. What is this one? Ellos y un pronombre. Yes, right? It is a pronoun. So this example, their bikes are in the garage. Sus bicicletas están en el garage. There. Estamos hablando de possessive adjectives, right? Because the bikes belong to them. La bicicleta me pertenecen a ellos. What about this one?
They are.
Is this a pronoun?
No.
It is not a pronoun. They are. ¿Verdad? So they are playing in the park. Or they're playing in the park. Same thing. Okay? Puedes usar el apóstrofe como puedes usarlo de esta manera. No importa. Los dos están correctos. Okay, lo que quiere decir es ahí hay. No es un pronombre que significa ellos. Entonces, ellos, pronombre. And what about this one? This is for me. Muy bien, lo digo. Allá, ¿verdad? There is milk in the fridge. Allá hay leche en la nevera. So it would be allá. What I'm going to say, it is over there. Está allá, right? It's correct. Very good. So I'm going to say, eso está allá. It is over there. Okay, ojo, están aquí. Aquí tienen los tres. Ok, con oraciones en ejemplo. Ok, the last one I'm going to talk about, and the reason I want to talk about it is because a lot of you had an error on this in your quiz. It's the difference of when do I use I and when do I use me. Okay, this is a big one. So, they both mean the same thing, right? They're both talking about me. ¿Verdad? Cuando decimos yo o yo en español, ¿verdad? Los dos significan lo mismo. Okay, so for example, the difference comes down on when you're using a word as a subject pronoun or as an object pronoun. Esta es la diferencia. Esto es subject pronoun. And this is object pronoun. What is a subject pronoun? What is a subject pronoun? You can tell me. Give me an example of a subject pronoun.
I'm going to you.
I'm going to the school. I is your subject pronoun. Why are you? ¿Qué está haciendo I en esa oración? O sea, que tú estás haciendo la acción o la estás recibiendo.
Haciendo
la acción, ¿verdad? So you're the doer. Right? You're doing the action. Tú estás haciendo la acción, ¿verdad? I am going to school, like Reina said. Okay? I can be Rodrigo, Yadira, Nina, Gaby, doesn't matter, you know, whoever. Going to school, they're doing the action. Okay? When you use me, cuando usamos me, we can say, for example, what is an object pronoun sentence? Who can give me an example?
Call me.
Correcto, los dos van a un sitio. Los dos están iniciando la acción y los dos están antes del verbo. Que es when. Okay. So I is doing that. And we can say here. What is happening on that sentence? ¿Qué me puedo decir? ¿Qué está surgiendo la oración? Y voy a preguntarle en esta fila. Where I'm listening, I'm hearing silence. Over here. What is receiving in that sentence? ¿Qué están recibiendo? The snacks. ¿Verdad? Estamos todas claras con eso. Mom bought me a snack. Mi mamá me compró un snack. Me está recibiendo el snack. Okay, you're not going to say, mom bought I a snack. You say, mom bought me a snack. Because it's a receiver. Or you can say, for example, what is that word? Arañar. Scratched. It's hard to pronounce. Scratch. Okay, so it's good. Okay, so pronounce the scratch. con la E silenciosa. We're going to have to scratch it. So we're going to say the cat scratched me. ¿Qué tal? ¿Qué yo estoy recibiendo? But I'm recibiendo una acción. I am receiving an action, even if it's not very pleasant. Scratch me. You're not going to say the cat scratched I. You're going to say the cat scratched me. Okay. When you are saying, I'm going to put a sentence, you're going to tell me which one. Okay. Voy a poner oración. Y me van a decir cuál es de los dos. So, for example, todo lo que acabo de borrar está aquí. Por si acaso, lo acabo de llegar. So, for example.
Hola, Sheila.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Bien.
Okay. Who would like to do that sentence? Magali. Okay, what is wrong with the sentence? A what?
Object pronoun.
Is an object pronoun? Is that object pronoun correct? What should be there?
I.
Jack and I. What did?
Porque va antes del verbo y está
porque está haciendo la acción.
Correcto. Jack and I got home late. La oración está hablando de Jack and I. Así que Jack and me, no puede ser porque mí no está recibiendo nada. Sencillamente, we have Jack and I. Okay, porque I está haciendo la acción. ¿Cómo saben eso?
Leyendo
oraciones. How do you know that? Reading your sentences. Let's try two more.
Erika. Okay. Like me, sister, I am.
I, very good. Lit. Lit. Imagínate que esto es una T.
Lit. My sister, I.
Is that correct?
No.
What do you need to change?
I need.
Correct. This the puppy lit. What's lit? Lamber. Pasado. And you're going to do a whole class of past tense that we never say igued. We never say that. We say lit with a T, con una T de pronunciación. Imaginándose que la T es una T. Y vamos a tener una clase entera de eso. My puppy lit my sister and me. Why? Why, Erika? Why me?
Porque me está lambiendo a mí.
Y tú estás recibiendo el lambiendo. You are receiving the lick, right? So in other words, it's me. One more. I don't know if I said it correctly. Sheila.
Uzi and I are best friends.
Very good. Susie and I. Why?
Me is my friend. It's me, mejor.
You're the doer, right? Susie and you are doing the action of the sentence. Muy bien. There was an error that a lot of you had in your exam. I'm going to put two, and I'm going to just quickly mention them. We said a lot of you had. Who's missing your test? So you can all see it. This side, my eye. Maddie, did you take this?
No.
Okay. So I have I have a test that has a mysterious. Alguien no puso nombre. I don't know who it is. I just recognized your letter. Okay. So, yes. Look at your E's. Look at your E's here and your E's there. That's you. I tried to figure that one out. Okay. And so a lot of you had, for example, on number 3, Henry and I went to the movies. A lot of you put me there, but Henry and I are doing the action. They're going to the movies. ¿Verdad? Están haciendo la acción, porque están yendo al cine. And there was another one, number 9. I met Valeria. Okay, this is number 9. I met Valeria and her at the movie theater. A lot of you put she there. Okay, she is a subject pronoun. Okay, and this sentence, let's read the sentence. I met Valeria and her at the movie theater. Is this an act doer?
No.
What are they receiving? They were met by someone, by me, at the theater. Ellos se encontraron con yo en el cine. Recibieron el encontrarse, okay? Por ende, no es I, es her. And why is it her? Because we're talking about another female. We're not talking about me, okay? That's why it's an object pronoun. Si vamos de nuevo a nuestro objeto pronombre, if you look at our object pronouns, her, ella, okay? Entonces, el segundo pronombre que aprendí. Okay, so that's why it was her and not she. Okay, is there any other questions on these? On I, me, or possessive pronouns, possessive adjectives? ¿Hay una pregunta? Esto es bien importante. Muchos de ustedes se confunden. Yo también me confundí muchísimo en esto. Okay, en muchas, pero no, hay muchas veces que todavía me confundo. Okay, y tengo que sencillamente pensar, okay, ¿quién es la acción? ¿Quién está haciendo la acción? ¿Estoy recibiendo o haciendo? Y si así sé, si uso I o uso me.
Yes. Entonces dijiste que los possessive pronouns reemplazan el sustantivo y se usa después del verbo.
Correcto. Se pueden usar antes del verbo a veces, pero nunca junto con el sustantivo. O sea que nunca vas a decir her book. Voy a decir this book is mine or this book is hers. Her y book no están en el, no están juntos. Como aquí están juntos. Uno al lado de otro. El pronombre con el sustantivo. Aquí, mira dónde está el pronombre y mira dónde está el sustantivo. Siempre separados. ¿Ok? Porque los reemplazo. De una manera que diríamos, esto es mío, en vez de decir, esto es tu jacket, esto es tuyo. Lo mismo. ¿Ok? ¿Any other questions? Acá sin duda, ahora. Maribel, ¿ok? Ok. Perfect.
Right. Gracias.
What we're going to do now, go back to my lesson plan. Okay, what we're going to do is within your groups, we are going to complete this pamphlet. Okay, en su grupo vamos a trabajar en este completo. Okay, so we're going to have, I'm going to clean up my mess here. We have Christina's group here. We have Judy, Erika, Reina, Adriana, and Miriam. Here we have Lori's group. Magali, Aneli, Dianel, Sheila, Veronica, and Gabby, you have a full group. Christina, you're missing two. And we have Brian with Mati, Carlos, Yanira, Rodrigo, Mireya. Brian, this is one. Lori, would you like a pamphlet? Is that helpful?
Sure.
Yeah. Same as Ryan.
Yeah.
So, this is here.
And you have your brother. This is our so this is the
It's a Yeah. Gracias. Maribel, ¿cómo va? El ejercicio.
Ya los hice, pero tengo una duda y te lo puse aquí en el chat.
Ok, perfecto.
Creo que sí estaba bien, pero me quedé con
los ¿Is this their car? Yes, it's theirs. Muy bien. ¿Is this her dog? Yes, it's hers.
En la primera tenía duda y le cambié. Si no era correcto, podría ser.
Lo tiene correcto. It's theirs.
Ok, porque te puse que estaba usando para hacer las preguntas el posesivo pronombre. Es usado por el posesivo adjetivo.
Correcto.
Ah, ok. Correcto.
El posesivo adjetivo usualmente es la pregunta y el posesivo pronombre usualmente la contestación.
Ok, ajá, esa era mi pregunta. Exacto. Ok, entonces estoy exacto. Bien.
Sigue ahí que va bien.
Gracias.
So the only thing that you were getting corrected. Thank you. Where is my, like, Yeah.
When does it happen? ¿Cuándo ocurre? Why did you choose to present this tradition? ¿Por qué escogieron presentar esta tradición? And why is it important to your family? ¿Por qué es importante para tu familia? Estas tres preguntas tienen que estar en su ensayo, de alguna manera. Okay? So the ones that I am missing, very quickly, Mati, ¿de qué quieres hablar?
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day. Navidad is out. Navidad ya lo pidieron tres personas. Okay. Ya diga. Día de muerto, que es la última día de Everyone else might have, right?
Lina, para yo ya
la acción de gracia
no está bueno. Pero podemos seguir ese patrón entonces para poder hacerlo porque yo lo hice en esta mañana y todo es interminable.
Sí, acuérdate, dos o tres párrafos, cuatro o cinco oraciones cada uno.
Ya, pero
así
o sea,
que
sí, está como que uno de esos
correcto. Solamente incluyeme estas tres preguntas en tu clase.
Yeah.
Yo no me lo vuelvo a escribir. Porque acuérdate que me escribiste ya.
Sí.
No, yo te lo puedo volver porque está en mi canal.
Sí, ok.
Any other questions? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? The most important thing, la cosa más importante. Si no vienen el lunes con su ensayo, no pueden ser parte de la editación en la clase. Ok. If you don't bring your essay, you're not going to be part of the editing process. So you're going to have an essay that is not edited. You're going to have an essay that is not edited. No sugiero que presente un ensayo que no esté corregido. Okay? So it's very important that all of you practice your writing this weekend. Set aside a day, pongamos al lado un día, o una hora, dos horas para escribir su ensayo. Okay?
Oh, dear. Yeah.
Right? This is the first of three. Okay, we're going to have three presentations. So, we won't do this. We're not going to do this. We're not going to do this.
¿Me mandas tu address?
Sí.
¿Por dónde vienes?
A los Blood Apartments.
¿Los Blood?
Sí, muy cerca.
Sí, está bien. Nos vemos en los siguientes.
Que tenga un bonito día.
Que me lleves a corregir.
Sí. Sí,
no se preocupe.
Ajá, sí. Cuídense mucho.
Sorry.
So nice to see you, Mary.
Likewise, Christina. I'll see you next week.